someone who was supposed to just clean house, cook food, or do prayers, is now busy in martial arts. This is how tradition has changed, and this is how, for good, females are being empowered. I have with me Kung Fu nuns, nuns of Drukpa lineage, who have just been awarded Asia's Game Changer Award. Hello and welcome. So what is the experience all about and how do you feel about it?
Actually, we are really happy and we are really proud, I think I would say. And what achievement we made, I mean what the award we got, is not only for us. It's a message and an empowerment for all the girls around the world that you are not less than anyone. You are maybe treated badly, you are maybe not given equal opportunities, but whatever opportunities you get in your life, you should just take it and go for it.
So another of your social work that I have been told and I have seen all over the internet, and I guess this is one of the best objectives that today's youth and authorities could have, that you have been conducting padyatras across Himalayan region, you have been conducting cycle journey across Himalayan region and collecting plastic waste and litter that tourism like tourists like us and many other tourists give away there, just throwing it away. So what do you have to say on this?
Actually, it's very sad that people have been littering plastic everywhere. I think it's a worldwide problem that there is lots of plastic and lots of non-biodegradable things. But I think it's a more of a problem in India, I would say, that people are like littering everywhere and throwing plastics and using more plastics, I think. And it's not only in the Himalayas we do padyatras and cycle yatras. We do it in whole India. We do it in south of India. We are in sometimes middle India. I think most of
India. Where is the plastic most found?
Mostly found, I think, in whole of the India, plastic is found. We are wherever we go for padyatra. Padyatra is a walking journey we do, and we pick up plastics and trash. I think plastic and trash, not only in plain Indias but also in the Himalayan part of India or the northern part of India, there is lots of plastic. Even in the places you wouldn't imagine there would be a plastic, like places like in the Himalayan region of lots of mountains and hills,
high
altituded hills, where you wouldn't think there would be a lot of living, but still there is plastic bottles and plastic packets and stuff. That's a really like disappointment for us. We cannot alone clean whole of the India or whole of the world, but we want to set a message, because in the rural areas, I think people, not only in the Himalayas but whole of the Indian rural people, really don't know about tourism, they don't know about plastic, they don't know about climate change or global warming. We want them to be educated, and educated enough that they can have a voice to say that don't bring plastic. Even if you bring it, take it back with you. But we try our best to bring it to a place they can recycle.
So do you see your award, do you see this will help in some way to the cause?
Getting this award, I think, is a big thing itself. But I think, yes, I think it will help a little, because once you are known in a way to the people that you do such kind of work, or you have a meaning of doing this kind of work, I think people will understand and get the message at least. Even if they don't do it, but I think one person can make the change, and we believe that no one is coming to save us. We have to be our own heroes. And that's why we started helping in earthquakes, rescuing animals, working with the environment. We don't think that we can change whole of the world. And we never thought that we will get an award or something, or we were doing it for an award goal. It wasn't like that, but it just happened like, it just went that way. And we got an award. And
so how has the routine of a nun been to lead into this space? I assume routine of a nun is never ever easy for a normal citizen like us. But then you are also indulged in martial arts. You are also teaching young women about self-defense. How has your routine been? How hard has it been?
Actually, when people see a nun, they think their life is very easy and very happy kind of life, where they don't have to do a lot, they have to sit and pray kind of thing. But I think our life, for, I don't know for everyone, but for Drukpa nuns, I would say it isn't easy. Mainly for Drukpa Kung Fu nuns, it's not easy, because waking up early in the morning at 3 a.m. and sleeping at 10, it's difficult. We have a lot of classes. We have to do lots of prayers. We have to learn lots of spiritual practice. We have to learn our meditations. And then there is Kung Fu. We every day have 2 hours of Kung Fu class. And with this, with whole of day, like full of routines and full of classes and stuff, we also have to do lots of social activities, like cleaning campaigns around Nepal, and then going on padyatras, going on cycle yatras. We have a really hard time, I would say. And I would say that being a nun is not for lazy people. We have to be really disciplined, you know.
So since your life is so hard, still you are doing so much for the society. What do you expect from the Indian government, or should I say from an international community, that how can they be part of your movement? How can they help you in this cause?
Actually, everyone is doing their own part. Everyone has a part in it. Even if it's the Indian government, even if it's then international parties, everyone is doing a part on their own. And I think that makes us really happy that there is someone who cares. There is someone that is there. I mean, there is someone who's standing there. It's not only us. There are people. There are lots and lots of NGOs. There are lots and lots of people around the world who have been doing great things. And we are really happy about it. That gives us lots of encouragement that like, really there are people who are making a change. And I think it's great. And if they come with us, even if they are not with us, I would say, not parting with us, or they're doing something good. And we are really happy about it.
What would be your message to Indian youth? Particularly the females, since your team has shattered a 1,000 year of tradition for good, but there are still females in tier 2, tier 3 city who are struggling to find their ways into mainstream. What would be your message to them?
Actually, my main message to all the women or all the girls around the world is believe in yourself. Believe in what you want to do. It's not important that you want to do Kung Fu. It's not important you want to be a doctor. It's not important that you are good in studies. It's okay if you are even a housewife. Be yourself, be authentic you, and be yourself, believe in yourself, whatever you are doing, because looking after the household is not easy, because everyone knows in India or around the world, if mom is not at home, it's a mess. It's a mess. Everyone knows that, and I think every youth can realize that.
So I should say, Kung Fu nuns are none of mother of Himalayan region. Because they're taking care of the region, putting away all the mess around.
Not mother of Himalayan region. Yeah. I don't think so, mother of Himalayan region. But yes, we are there. We are there. But there are other people who are there. And we are really happy about it. And we want more and more people to join to this good cause. And if not only girls, but I think whole of the youth. Because, see, youth is the future of our country. Youth is the future of our, like, the next generation. They would be what we will be like. We will be there for next 30 years maybe, and then they will come and they will be the next generation. So I think they should be more understanding about how important our nature is. Everyone around the world talks about global warming, everyone talks about deforestation, everyone talks about climate change, but there are people who have interest in it and there are people who don't have interest in it. If I think we educate our youth properly on how environment is important, how a girl child is important, how gender equality is important, we don't say that we only stand for girls, but the problem is there is no chance for the girls now. That's why we are standing for girls. If it was for the boys, maybe we would have stood for the boys. Right. So it's not about like we don't like boys or some like that kind of thing. But it's like there is no chance for the girls. We want girls to have their own voice and come out in the world and make a difference.
Thank you so much for talking to us. It was nice seeing the presentation, and I congratulate you once again and hope you will have a
bright future ahead. It was really nice talking to you too. Thank you.